All right, everybody, welcome back to Exercises of the Week. We got David Cameron here with us again. We're going to do another lower body exercise, a common piece of equipment called the leg curl. This week, the exercise is actually a seated leg curl, great exercise for strengthening the back of your thighs called the hamstrings. Okay, really important exercise for just total lower body strength, but really important for stabilizing the knee, also helpful for strengthening the glute muscles, so your butt muscles, okay? So, a couple different ways to perform a leg curl. This is one variation called a seated leg curl. You may also have seen a leg curl where you're lying flat down and pulling up. We just don't have that piece of equipment here. We have the seated leg curl, okay? So, David, why don't you grab a seat in there. So you're gonna grab a seat and I'll kind of walk you through what we're gonna do. So don't put your feet up here just yet. So as with the leg extension, which we've shown you before, we wanna have this seat set so that the middle of David's knee is lined up with that pivot point. And right now, if his knee is bent, it's up here, it's a little bit far. So I'm gonna move this seat back, maybe one or two notches. I'm gonna have to lean forward just so you get Okay, so now let's put your right leg up top and then your left leg. Yeah, you gotta turn to your side a little bit. See how we're looking for weight there. That weight should be fine. Okay, so I'm looking at his knee and that's lined up pretty good. This isn't a perfect science, but that's pretty good. It's about lined up. If David said he was more comfortable with the seat one back, that's not gonna make or break this particular exercise, okay? So now that we've got that, we're gonna pull that pin out there. And this is gonna get snug against your thighs. That's just gonna keep the thighs down, okay? We're not gonna need to adjust this right now because I know it's set up. Is any part of this painful or uncomfortable? Okay. If David said this, just getting his feet into this position was uncomfortable, we could lower or change the starting position to move it down by pulling this pin out and moving it up a little bit. We don't need to worry about that because David's comfortable in this position. So, as with every exercise, that proud chest is the focus, and you can hold on to here, and we're gonna pull this pad down so that it goes basically as far down as you can. For some people, we say your calves touching the back of the pad. Not everybody can do that. Basically, slow and controlled as far down as you can. So let's see what we got here. And again, that's slow and controlled on the way up. David mentioned that in one of our past episodes, just the importance of both motions, controlling them. And it really is important for strengthening, firming, and toning to control both motions. And to a certain extent, the slower the better. We normally suggest about a 2-4 count. So about 2 seconds for this part, so a little bit faster there, actually a lot faster there. And then 4 seconds here, 2, 3, and 4. So try and get that 2-4 count. So on the way down, so 1-1000, 2-1000, all the way down, and then on the way up, 4. 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, 4-1000. So that's good. So you keep going, okay? So David's going slower than what most would do, but he's in pretty good shape. If you go too slow, you are gonna find it's a lot more difficult than it needs to be, okay? So good things that are happening here. Nice proud chest. Sometimes on this exercise, there's a tendency to slide forward a little bit, so you want to make sure you're not sliding forward too much. It's a natural tendency to move a little bit far forward. The other thing is we want to make sure you're going through what we call the full range of motion. So as David's pushing down, I want to make sure he's coming down as far as he can. Now, some people have got really tight hamstrings from sitting at a desk all day. If they're not able to come down all the way because of tight hamstrings, well, that's kind of a sign that we're gonna need to work with them on some flexibility exercises. Obviously, if the weight's too heavy, and that's why they can't push it down, we're gonna need to lighten up the weight a little bit. But David seems fine on this particular exercise. So, I think we're set up pretty good, and we pointed out the main things. And let's do two more repetitions. There's one, slow and controlled. Yeah, and let's make this your last. Boom, that's good. That's your last one.
I find the more you do it, the able to control or return instead of being a jerk return, it's more fluid.
Good point. So what David mentioned is he finds it's easier the more he does it to control this part of the motion. There's no question early on in your first couple of weeks, you're not gonna be able to go that slow. And if you're trying to go that slow, you're probably gonna find your body's kind of shaking a little bit. So slow and controlled is good, but you don't need to be excessively slow because quite honestly, you're gonna make the exercise harder than it needs to be. So that's the seated leg curl. Thanks for checking in for this week's exercise of the week.